أنا وحالي مسجدكم. الله أكبر.
Yaakob, you know this is not your house. Yeah, you are stealing my house.
And if I don't steal it, someone else is going to steal it.
If you want to look at the history of this, you have to go back to 1876. There are two Jewish small communities, Sfaradi and Ashkenazi, bought some land in Sheikh Jarrah. Because it's a holy place, there is the tomb of Shimon HaTzadik. And they built some houses there. And all in all, lived peacefully with their Arab neighbors. Then came 1948. People fled the war. Mainly it were Palestinians that were pushed out of their houses or fleeing from the war. But there was a case also of Jewish small communities fleeing from the eastern side to the western side. Until 1967, East Jerusalem was under Jordanian. And these families that lived there were compensated and been rehoused inside Israel. The Jordanian, together with UN organization, built on this land. They built some 28 houses for Palestinian refugees. They were promised by the Jordanian government to legalize their residency there. 67 changed the nature of the conflict by the occupation of East Jerusalem, by Israel, the annexation. And gradually, some settlements or organization close to the settlement realize that they can go and demand these houses through the legal system. And it has to do with the absentee property law that Israel enacted already in 1950s. Those are not the families or the heirs of the families that used to live there. And that's what makes it political. Sheikh Jarrah is a Palestinian neighborhood. The vast majority of people live there are Palestinians. Also its location so close to the old city. You're talking about the settler community and probably the most extreme part of the settler community that deliberately wants to live there in order to prevent Jerusalem from ever becoming the capital of a future Palestinian state.